This video will show you how to change the size of the brush and the length of the brush stroke in the Paint Synthesizer editor. And we will touch upon some Paint Synthesizer modulators that affect the shape of the brush stroke. I'm going to start with an auto paint preset called Acrylic Dry Brush, which is located in the Natural Media category in the Auto Paint collection in the Paint Synthesizer. The first thing I'm going to do is to change this preset from an auto paint preset to a manual paint preset. I'll do this by changing the pen type from Auto Draw Interactive, which looks like this, to Interactive Pen, which looks like this. Right now the paint is getting the color from the source image. If I change to the color tab in the source area, the color will now come from the color wheel. The easiest way to change the brush width is to hold down the B key and draw the size you want into the canvas. Another way is through the brush source panel. You can change the horizontal and vertical of the brush here. I'm going to reload this preset and show you how to change the path length for auto or assisted painting. And I will switch back to source image so I can auto-paint the source. Studio Artist's paints can be very complex as there are a lot of modulators. I'm going to show you a few so you can get familiar with how the paint engine functions. I'm first going to start loop action so I can show you these edits in real time. As you can see, there are these squiggly lines. That tells me there is modulation going on somewhere. And there are several places where this could be happening. Let's look at path randomization. All of these are turned off so the modulation is not happening here. But while we're here, let's look at a few of these randomization settings. I'm going to crank up the amount so we can see the effect better. Now let's look at path angle. Here I can see that there is this angle mod here. So when I turn it off, the squiggly lines go away. However, the path is still trying to orient the paint strokes by curving around the source image, so there is still angle modulation going on, which is orienting the paint strokes to the source image. The curving comes from the path shape panel. I'll show you that in a second. First, I'll show you a few more options here in path angle. If I turn the multiplier down here, the lines will shorten. But the best place to change the length is in path shape, and we will go there next and adjust the paint stroke length. I've noticed the painting has stopped even though I have loop action going. That's because there is an inhibitor in this preset. There are many ways to inhibit the painting. In this case, it is happening in path start. This inhibitor is just one of many possibilities. Skip blanking prevents overdrawing. This setting also speeds up the rendering process by strategically laying down the paint. If I change this to face feature point only, the painting will be restricted to the face area. I'm going to turn this inhibitor completely off for now. You can change the length of the paint stroke here in path shape. You can also modulate the paint length as well. As I said before, the path angle was set to orient itself around the source image and was doing it with curves. And that's set here as path type. If I change it to lines, it will look like this. It will still be orienting around the source image, but instead of curves, it will be lines. Here are a couple of other examples. There's also these two stylize options where you can further modulate the path. Let me show you a few. Now I'm just going to go between path shape and the brush source to show you how you can interactively lay down paint and then hone in the length and the width. Now I'll put back that inhibitor to paint in the face area only. So that's the basics of brush width and path length and shape.